Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's tutorial is ponytail hairstyles. I think all of these are super cute. Let me know which one is your favorite down in the comment section. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to create a pull-through braid on the side of my head going into a ponytail. So with my hair parted on the right side, I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the left side, right on my hairline, and tie this off using an elastic band. Then I'm going to clip this out of the way and divide off a second section of hair right behind it. So from right in front of my left ear and up to my part line, I'm going to comb through this and tie it off using another elastic band. Now that I have my two sections, I'm going to take the first ponytail and divide it into two sections. Then I'm going to pull the second ponytail through the middle and clip it out of the way. Now I'm going to take the two sections of the first ponytail and combine them back together. Then I'm also going to divide off a new section of hair and combine it with this first ponytail. Then using an elastic band, I'm going to tie off the section and create a new ponytail. Now I can let down the section that was clipped away, and I'm going to go back over the section that's in between the two elastics and gently pull on the edges of the hair to make it wider and more full. And you'll notice that I still have two ponytails, so now I'm going to repeat those same steps again. So I'm taking the first ponytail and splitting it into two pieces. Then I'm going to pull the second ponytail through the middle and clip it out of the way. Then I'm going to put the two sections of the first ponytail back together and combine them with a new section of hair from the left side of my head and from along the back of my head, following down from the part line. I'm going to tie off the section with another elastic band to create a new ponytail section. And then I'm going to let down the section that was clipped away. And now I can go back over the looped section in between the two elastics and gently pull on the edges to make them wider and more full. And now I'm going to create one more section of the pull-through braid before I do the ponytail. So again, I'm splitting the first ponytail into two sections, pulling the second ponytail through the middle and clipping it out of the way. Then I'm going to combine the two halves of the first ponytail back together, along with a new section of hair and tying it all together with another elastic band. Then I can let down the clipped section and pull on the edges of the looped section to create a puffier section of the pull-through braid. Now I'm going to do the ponytail portion of the style. So I'm going to split the top ponytail into two sections, like I have been, and wrap them around the second ponytail. Then I'm going to pull the second ponytail aside, but I'm going to combine the two sections of the first ponytail with the rest of the hair and combine it all together at the base of my head where I want my ponytail to sit. And once it's all combined, then I'm going to add in the second ponytail and tie it all together using a hairband. The hairband will help create the last section of the pull-through braid, and then once it's all tied off, I can cover the band. So I'm just dividing off a section of hair, wrapping it around the hairband, and securing it underneath using a bobby pin. The next hairstyle, I'm going to divide off two sections of hair from above both of my ears and twist this section together. Then I'm going to tie the two sections together using an elastic band. And now I'm going to cover the elastic. So I'm taking my topsy-tail tool and I'm going to slide it underneath the elastic all the way to the looped section at the top. Then I'm going to divide off a section of hair from the ponytail and wrap it around the elastic band. I'm going to pull the ends through the top looped portion of the tool and then pull the tool the rest of the way down, and this will pull the ends underneath the elastic so it'll hold it in place without needing to use a bobby pin. So now I'm going to go back over the two twists and gently pull on the edges so they're softer and more full. Then next I'm going to divide off two sections of hair from the back of my head right underneath the twist. And I'm going to tie these two sections together on top of the previous section using another clear elastic band. Then I'm going to go back over the two sections and gently pull them out of the elastic so they're puffier. Then I'm going to cover the elastic band again using my topsy-tail tool. Now I'm going to divide off two new sections of hair, bring them over the top section, and then tie them together at the back of my head with another elastic band. Then I'm going to gently pull on small sections of hair to make them fuller and more puffy. Then I'm going to cover the elastic band again using my topsy-tail tool. Now I'm going to create one more section of the ponytail, so I'm taking the last two sections of hair and I'm going to wrap them over the previous section and then tie them together. I'm going to gently pull on the edges again to make them fuller. And then to finish the ponytail, I'm going to combine all of the hair together at the bottom and tie it off using a clear elastic band. And then of course I'm going to cover the elastic band using my Topsytail tool again. I think this is such a pretty elegant hairstyle. It could easily be worn as an everyday hairstyle, but I love that it's done with elastics. It makes it a lot more secure, so it's definitely not going to fall out throughout the day. The next hairstyle is so simple and quick, but looks so unique. So I'm going to start by brushing my hair into a high ponytail. Then I'm going to tie it off with a hairband and cover the elastic with a section of hair. And then about halfway down the ponytail, I'm going to tie another elastic band over the hair. Then I'm going to create a gap in the hair right above the elastic and flip the ends into the gap so the two sides are twisted now. Then I'm going to go back over the two twisted sides and carefully pull on the edges to give them extra volume. I want them to be a lot bigger and more fluffy. Then to hide the elastic band at the bottom, I'm going to take a small section of hair and wrap it around the elastic band. Then hold it in place by sliding a bobby pin over the wrapped piece and through the elastic underneath the ponytail. I just love this hairstyle. It's so simple and quick, but looks so unique. It kind of looks like a braid and a lot more complicated to do than it actually is, but it is so quick and easy. For the rope twist ponytail, I'm going to start by dividing off a section of hair at the top of my head. This is going to be the first section that I start the style with, so I'm going to wrap this up and clip it out of the way. Now I'm going to divide off another section of hair, so starting at my temples, I'm going to trace a line back towards the back of my head and smooth down the hair with my comb. Then I'm going to tie off the section using a clear elastic band. Now I'm going to take this ponytail and clip it out of the way with the first section of hair. And then I'm going to divide off a new section of hair. So I'm going to start an inch down from the previous section and divide off the hair at the back of my head. Then I'm going to tie it off with another clear elastic band and clip it out of the way with the previous two sections. Then I'm going to take the remaining hair and tie it together into a final ponytail. Now that I've prepped my hair into the ponytail sections, I'm going to create the rope braid part of the hairstyle. So I'm going to take the very top section and divide it into two pieces, a left side and a right side. I'm going to cross the left side over the right side. And now I'm going to take the first ponytail and split it into two sections as well and add them into the above two sections that I've been twisting. So I still have a left side and a right side. And I'm going to twist the two sections and cross the left side over the right side again. And then I'm going to twist the sections and cross the left side over the right side again. And then I'm going to take the next ponytail and divide it into two more sections and add them into the previous sections that I've been twisting together. Now I can twist the two sections and cross the left side over the right side again. Then I'm going to twist them around each other once more until the two sections reach the very last ponytail. And now I'm going to tie off the end of the braid with the last section of hair to create the final ponytail. Once that's done, I can go back over the twist and make it fuller. So I'm just going to gently pull on the outside edges of the twist until they're bigger so they stand out more. And this would be such a great style for playing sports or really anything active because putting the hair into elastics first will really help the hairstyle stay in place. I've done this a few other times and I definitely have found that this is the easiest way to do this hairstyle and to make sure that it stays in all day. For the next style, I wanted this to be a really smooth, sleek style, so I'm actually working with clean, straight hair, and then I'm going to brush all of my hair together at the nape of my neck. Then I'm going to grab a clear elastic band and tie the hair into a low ponytail. Now I'm going to do the wrapped portion of the style, so what I'm going to do is divide off a small section of hair from my ponytail and begin wrapping it around the ponytail. So starting at the top, I'm going to wrap it a couple times around the elastic band first. Then I'm going to continue wrapping the small section of hair down the length of the ponytail until I get to the end of the piece of hair that's being wrapped. Then I'm going to grab a bobby pin and pin the wrapped piece against the ponytail on the underside. And you just want to slide the bobby pin along the wrapped piece as much as you can so it's held in place really well. I actually did this style two different ways, one using elastics to hold the wrapped piece and one with bobby pins, and I found that the hairstyle stays a lot cleaner when using bobby pins, so you can do it either way. Try them both and see which one you like better. Then I'm going to divide off a new section of hair from the ponytail and repeat the same steps again, wrapping the piece down the length of the ponytail, starting where the first section ended, and then pinning it in place again with more bobby pins. When wrapping the section of hair, I tried to keep it as flat as possible as well, and once I did two sections, I decided to stop, though you could continue wrapping the ponytail as much or as little as you'd like. But I think this hairstyle is so cool. I love the sleek look of it, and it's of course easier to do than it looks. For the next hairstyle, I've parted my hair on the right side, and then I'm going to divide off the two side sections above both my left and right ears. Then I'm going to put the rest of my hair up to see where I want my ponytail to sit. Once I can see where it'll be, I'm going to divide off the section of hair right above it at my crown. I'm going to tie this section off using a clear elastic band and use this as the base for my hairstyle. And then I'm going to take the hair from my right side and wrap it around the elastic band of the crown section. Then I'm going to pin it in place with a couple bobby pins. And then I'm going to take the section from the left side of my head and do the same process, draping the section around the elastic band from the crown section, and then pin it underneath with some more bobby pins. Now I'm going to combine the remaining hair together and tie it into a ponytail underneath the wrapped part of the hairstyle using a hairband. And once it's tied off, I'm going to use my Topsy-Tail tool to cover the hairband. I love this ponytail style. It's so classy and clean, but it definitely looks a lot harder than it actually is. The last ponytail is so quick and easy. It's great for days when you're running late. So for this style, I'm going to part my hair on the right side and then pull out some pieces to frame my face. So now I'm going to combine all of my hair together at the nape of my neck and tie it off using a hairband. Then I'm going to slide the hairband down a tiny bit and create a gap in the hair above the hairband. And then I'm going to flip the ends around the elastic band so the two sides are twisted. And then I'm going to go back over the twists and gently pull on the edges to make them fuller. And I'm also going to gently pull on small sections of the crown just to add some texture to the style. And then to finish it off, I'm going to wrap my all-over pearl scrunchie from my store, Missy Sue Shop, over the hairband to cover it up.
That's the end of today's video. Thank you so much for watching as always. Let me know which was your favorite down in the comments. Like and subscribe, click that bell. That way you'll never miss future videos, and I will see you on the next one.